Professor, you forgot to open the microphone.
Okay. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you now.
Okay, sorry, I have to start it again. Okay, I have talked a lot. Okay, so I will start with the outlines of the topics that I would like to talk today. First of all, I would like to review you about the nested loop, right? I have said that nested loop is very important in C programming, because as just told you, right, to write a program or to use a computer for calculating something, right? It is about to calculate something repeatedly. So repeatedly means you have to do it in loop, right? So in C programming, for loop, while loop, or do while loop, they will be very important for writing a program. So you need to know about how to some examples about the nested loop, right? That is what I'm going to talk to you before I will go to the detail of the topics that I would like to teach today. That is about the array, right? And after the array, I will also give you an example, a good example of how to use array, right? That is a string, right? Because in C programming, you don't have the string data type. So what we have to do is we have to decrypt as an array of characters. So I will talk about this into detail as well. And today I will end up the topics or the class with the multi-dimensional arrays. That is a complex form of the array that, and you will have some, yeah, this is also important as well. So I will start with the nested loop, right? To create pyramid and pattern, right? So, okay, I will start from the easiest one, right? The easiest one. So I would like you to have C program to print triangles using asterisks, right? Number and characters. So I will start from the, to print a half pyramid first, right? So if I would like you to write this form, right? How can we do? So you have to start, write the star sign or asterisk, right? One asterisk, two, three, four, and five, right? So you need to do for loop, right? That is the easiest one, right? So we have to start from, okay, you have to enter the number of rows, right? And scan if person's ID. Don't forget ampersand and rows. This is a common or typical C program, right? This is a part, and then you have to end up with the return zero, right? If you decrement as an integer function, right? So in this way, you have to declare I and J, right? As the outer for loop, right? I start from one to the rows, right? You need to start from one and then less than or equal sign and rows plus I. This is a form of the for loop, right? Outer loop. And for inner loop, you also have to use the J, right? And J, you can write it down like J from one to J less than or equal to I. Why J is less than or equal to I? Because in general, if you want to write like a square, right? For five asterisk, five column of asterisk and five rows of asterisk, right? You can just simply write it one, two rows and J from one, two rows as well. But if you want to just increase it by one for each loop, right? So you need to set up the ending number here as I. Why? Because for the first loop, right, you have start I from 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, right? 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So this is the number of asterisks here will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as well. So the inner loop J will start from 1 to J less than or equal to I. This is the meaning of how to write the number of asterisk in the ascending order. Okay, so this is a form that you may have to remember, but if you practice it more, you don't have to remember. You can just use it intuitively. Okay, so in this sense, inner loop, right? Right after you print out every asterisk for that line, so you need to print out backslash n here in order to show the carriage return and right feet. Okay, carriage return and right feet, right? This is a compound character, right? For the, let's say in the window program, right? You need to, actually it's not just only one character, I have already told you, right? It is the compound character. Compound characters mean it combine two characters at a time, right? It's the carriage return and right feet. And then, so the inner loop, right? Inner loop, you can just simply put asterisk inside and that's all. Okay, print out asterisk sign. And then you need to maybe to put some spaces for a few spaces for the blank or for the tab, right? Okay, so it's very simple. Okay, so I skip to a bit difficult. Not actually difficult. This is just to print the constant asterisk. But if you want to print out the 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on, right? So first of all, you need to get the number of the rows to be printed out, okay? And in this case, like, you may have to use in many specific examples, specific cases. For example, if you want to do in while loop, right? But once the loop increased, so you need to increase the number of times inside the loop, okay? So you may need to use this kind of program, C program, right? So they're similar. So you need to start with the same thing, right? To start from this pattern or this structure, right? And then you just put I to from 1 to 2 rows, and then in a loop, right? I from 1 to 2J less than or equal to I, and then print out the number, right? In this case, you can print out the number J, right? J will stand for the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on until the rows. Okay, so this one is very similar to the previous programs, right? So if you want to instead print out an integer, you can if you want to print out an alphabet or a set of alphabets, how can we do? As we have known that A, right, is a character, right? But itself, right? Actually, if it is declared as a character, right? But in fact, you need to keep it in main memory, in memory as an integer for the byte, for 1 byte, right? Or 8 bits. Okay, so and the character or the ASCII code or character code is 65, but just in case that you don't remember A, right? The ASCII code of A that is 65, you can just simply use you can subtract with character A. For example, if you want to print the uppercase character until the uppercase character E, right? So the input will be second F person size C and then get input. For this example, I get input E, right? Capital E, right? So the for loop will start from 1 to the input E. I don't know E, the ASCII code of E, right? But I know the, I don't know the, as suppose I don't know the ASCII code of A as well. So what I have to do is I just subtract the input character with the capital A and then plus one, right? We can get the exact ASCII code of E. And then, okay, if for inner loop, right, we can just just for do for loop I from J from 1 to I, right, and then pin F percent sign alphabet, right? When we use alphabet here, even alphabet here is character, right? And then the first character will be printed out will be 65 ASCII coordinate is capital A. And then for character, right, in C program, as I told you that it is the same as you can treat a character the same as integer. So you can use plus plus alphabet. Alphabet was declared as a character. Okay, so it can be treated as a byte or integer, just one byte. So you can use plus plus or increment operator like this, unary operator increment like this. And then don't forget to print out backslash n and then go back to do the for loop, outer for loop. And then you can go to b and then print b two times and then up new line and then go back to increase the character to C, capital C, and then print out C three times and so on, right? So this is the way that this program does. Okay, so in this program, I just want to show you that the transformation between character and integer. The character, the integer of a character is an ASCII code of itself. So you need to know that, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, we go to the example 4 and 5, right? If you want to print half pyramid in inverted half pyramid, right? So you need to start from the number of the number of the rows, right? Like this, like in opposite direction. So what you have to do is just simply change the direction I from rows to 1, right? And then you can use minus minus I. Similarly to the case of J, right? J, you can still have the same format like this, and then you can print out, okay? So you in this example, you can just simply change this row, right? I from 1 to rows, you can change from I from rows to 1. And then don't forget to use minus minus I, that is to decrement I by 1. Okay, so you can do the same things to print out the number like this, so you can get the program like this. Okay, and then this is the more difficult things, right? If you want to print out the full pyramid, right, so it need to be symmetric form, right? So in the previous slide, you can just simply put print out only half of pyramid like this, a triangle. But in this case, if you want to do this, right, what shall we do? So if you can see that for the first line, you need to add up some spaces, right? How many spaces do we have to add up before you write the first asterisk? You need to be calculated, right? And for the second line, you need to calculate for the space left as well. Okay, so in this way, you have to start from the, okay, get the input of the number of the rows that you would like to print out, right? The pyramid of asterisk like this. So what should we do? Okay, so you may have to get the number of the rows first. Don't forget to put the ampersand here. So the outer loop will be I from 1 to rows and then plus plus I. And then you can see that if you want to increment or interesting, why do I have to put K here? Even I put K already. Okay, it seems like K has to be set to 0 every time that the I increment. It means that for every outer loop, right, it has changed I have been changed, so K we have to set for 0 all the time. I mean after the loop, the inner loop finish the process. Okay, so for the inner loop, right, you need to add up more space, right? So you have to calculate, right, this space from 1 to 2 lows minus I, right? And then pin space, right? So you can just print out the space right before the asterisk. For example, if you want to print the first line, you need to print out 4 space right before star. So you can just print the space from 1 to rows minus I. Row is 5, I is 1. So for the first line, you need to put the space for 4 spaces. Okay, and then you can do this loop, right? And then here is just like to print out the number of the asterisks, right? Yk is not equal to I to multiply by I minus 1. So you can see that from this program, right? You can print the first loop, you print 1 asterisk or 1 star. The second, you print 4 or 3 stars. The fourth line, you will, or the third line, you will print 5 stars. And so on, right? So the number of stars you are going to print out will be 2 multiplied by I minus 1. 2 multiplied by I minus 1. For this example, I is 1, so you can print out 1. If I is 2, you print 4 or with 3. If I is 3, you can print 5 and so on, right? So in this way, right, you can use for loop or you can use while loop. It depends. Okay, and then you can print until k is less than this, right? So this is the number of stars you are going to print out. And then don't forget to put printf / n. And then you can do the same thing like this. Mm-hmm. I think. Okay, this is why k need to set as 0 all the time when you finish this line and then you finish this for loop, this outer for loop, right? And then when you go back to for loop, so I plus plus or plus plus I will be done, and then k will set to 0 every time. Okay, so actually it can be noticed that if you don't want to write this here, you can put plus plus I and k is equal to 0 right after this printf / n here. So the program will do the same thing. Okay? Any questions? Okay, I think you all can do it. And then it doesn't matter if you just simply print out the star signs like this. But what if you want to print like this? 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, so on. Okay, you can try yourself, right? It seems like you can just simply change only in this way, in this while loop here. Okay. So what I have just taught to you is I want to bring you step by step from the easiest programming nested loop to the more complicated nested loop, right? So we come up with this one, right? So okay, if you start from this, if I start or ask you to do this assignment or this example first, you will, oh, it's so difficult, right? But if I just increase your knowledge step by step, right, I think you can do this one not so difficult. Okay, so you can see that this is start from 1, start from 2, start from 3, right? 3, 4, 5, 4, 3. If you could remember, we have already Pitam has given you a palindrome, right? This is a kind of palindrome, right? 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3. okay, this is a palindrome, right? You may know about this, right? And how to write the palindrome, you can use this, okay. Count is less than rows, and then you can print starting from the number, right? And then just increase it. Uh-huh. Print out I plus K. Okay, I start from 1, I plus K, K is 0, so we print out 1 first. But for the second line, start with 2, I will 2 plus K, K start from 0, right? Mm-hmm. If count less than rows, so you can increase the number. But if count is equal to row, is greater than row. Okay, maybe you can check it out. Okay, so I just don't want to waste the time, right? Maybe you can check. I think it's not difficult. And how to write the inverted full pyramid, right? You can also, okay, starting from rows and end up with 1, right? And use minus minus I. Okay, maybe some of you would like to try to practice some examples. So you can use this lab, right? So you need to know, write C program to print for a triangle. For a triangle will be like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is a for a character. Or print the Pascal triangle. Pascal triangle, you may, do you remember Pascal triangle? You use a Pascal triangle to calculate for the binomial coefficient that you use in the part of the polynomial. A plus B square, right? It will be A square plus 2AB. A square plus 2AB plus B square, right? So in order to get the coefficient in front of the polynomial terms, you may need to calculate for the Pascal triangle or the binomial coefficient. In order to calculate for that, you can just simply use this one, right? If the I and J is equal to 0, right? Coefficient will be 1 and j, right? I and I or j, if it, they are equal to c, 1. If they are equal to 0, 0 means this row, right? It will equal to 1. Otherwise, it will be the coefficient will be coefficient multiplied by I minus j plus I divided by j. Okay, this is a rule, right? You can use this one. Okay. And then try to print out the Pascal triangle like this. Okay, try. And then the last one will be the lab. Okay, that you may have to try to write a program to calculate for the standard deviation. So the input will be a series of integers or the scores, right? Maybe you can end up with 0, right? After you get the sequence of number, right? And then you have to calculate their standard deviation, okay? The standard deviation can be computed from the summation of I minus the average of the set of numbers, okay? And then sum square, right? Sum square, and then divided by n, and then you put the square root. You can use the square root from the function mat.h, right? You can try to calculate for this. Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay. And until this, do you have any questions?